Amandla.
Please.
Amandla.
Please.
Long live the veterans of the African National Congress. Long live.
Long live.
Long live the standards of the African National Congress. Long live.
Long live.
Long live the African National Congress. Long live.
Long live.
Long live the SACP. Long live.
Long live.
Long live COSAC. Long live.
Long live.
I was told that I was going. I should take less than 2 minutes, which of course I agree with because I have a very easy task. But on the issue of talents, and I think I've gazed through, although there's a blinding light, the whole year. I can identify 3 stalwarts. Umam Shaw, Getu Shaw. I think I regard it as a stalwart. I think Comrade President Thabombe, I regard him as a stalwart. He has led the African National Congress for 2 terms, 10 years, and he has been in the leadership of the African National Congress for many years, and he has led our government for a very long time as well. So I regard him as a standard of this movement. I can see others who are approaching the standardship. On the question that, on the issue that Umar said, fleetingly here, I was also called by journalists to say, don't you have contacts there in Zimbabwe? Who would? And I said, no. And you see, because it's a very difficult situation. No, the architecture which we have been working on, in fact, for which Comrade President Mbeki worked on, of course, from the time of our departed Comrade President Mandela, was such that we wanted to put paid to military coups in Africa. And military coups in Africa have no place at all. I remember I went to a conference in Nigeria on militaries in democracies, and we discussed this very same issue. And because of our strong views about the role of militaries, that militaries are subservient to politics, people came around, and I quoted then an address that was made by Mandela to the military council in Pretoria. At one time, when he seemed to think that something was going there, where he said that, you know, this hard-won freedom of the people of South Africa will never be undermined by the military. If any such thing were to happen, our people would smash those tents with their bare fists. And that was the tenor generally through that conference, because I quoted that, and I'm happy that in Nigeria since the time of Abaj, nothing like this has happened. And in fact, when things like this happen in West Africa, there is immediate action on the part of the West African community. That is why I think, because of this architecture that was built, even what is happening in Zimbabwe has been so circumspect that there isn't a debate about whether this is a coup or not. Because that's why you still see Mugabe there, and they're trying to find a way, because it It's unacceptable that militaries get involved in politics. That was just a digression, Congress. I am, because I've been told that. Now, I'm supposed to talk on the commissions, give guidance on commissions. Now, as you see, I'm getting as confused as sitting here. Six, from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Those commissions, I think they are there in your pack. Six commissions. The first one is organizational renewal. I'm supposed to talk to the outcomes, but I think that I'm advised that the outcomes, the commissions themselves will determine. But of course, when we discuss organizational renewal, we are doing so with the background that has been given already during inputs by civil society, during inputs by Comrade Sydney here, that we want to do something about this organization of ours that seems to flounder. Because without a strong organization, we cannot have a strong state, we cannot have sustainable economic development, and everything else flows from this organization. Even the National Democratic Revolution that we espouse with our allies is not possible without a strong organization. The presenter there will be Dr. Thabang Makwetla, the facilitator, Taminde Ndaba. Now, in all these commissions, there will be rapporteurs and scribes determined in the communicated on in the commissions themselves. And of course, all these commissions are going to report back to plenary, and plenary is going to endorse the recommendations of those commissions or deal with them in a manner in which plenary sees fit. We don't have time here to have people presenting. So those people, Comrades must go to these commissions, and I hope many of you have read through the documentation that was given, which deals with organizational renewal, the state, sustainable economic development, and so on. The second commission will be on the role of the state in fostering sustainable economic development. I think you have heard that our country's economy is in a parlous state. We have been reduced to near junk status, which makes it very difficult for our economy to grow. And it's very difficult for us to therefore attend to the many myriad social problems that we have, like education, or free education, and relieving the state of unemployment, reducing unemployment, and so on. Comrade Alec Erwin will present, and the facilitator will be Sihle Moon. The politics of the constitution today, we know that we have a very strong constitution, which is a bulwark against many of the abuses that we might otherwise be facing. And thanks, of course, to Comrade Oliver Tambo, who had the foresight, long before our democracy, to ensure that we prepare for a constitution as strong as the one we have today. On electoral reform, you know that there has been a strong view presented that perhaps the reason why we have these problems that we have is because our elected officials in parliament are not answerable to constituencies. And some of the views here on electoral reform, we'll talk to that. And Comrade Omri, who has been championing this idea of electoral reform, will present, and the facilitator will be Bina Malini. Challenges of building a non-racial society. You know, as we flounder, as we do the things we do, all these things about corruption that is so prevalent in our country affects this central mission of our democracy to create a non-racial society. Apart from things that may be verbalized that seem to detract from this agenda of ours, the things that we do, what people see we do, because they begin to look at us and say, no, these people say they want to create a non-racial, democratic, non-sexist South Africa, but the things that they do don't point to it. So it's an important thing to discuss, and Comrade Kesha Shilubani will talk to that, and it was facilitated by Abba Omar. The relationship between civil society, ANC, and the state, which is what yesterday we were actually talking to, and which is also what we always talk to, that you know, when we struggled, we may be members of the African National Congress, but the idea that we're struggling for the African National Congress is just talking quiet. We were struggling so as to liberate the people of South Africa from the bondage, from the yoke of apartheid. So this is an important thing to talk to, so that the African National Congress begins to again internalize this relationship between civil society, the state, and the African National Congress. And the facilitator there is Comrade Mandla Komfe and Ntombazana Kuwetha, who's not exactly a stellar, but is a veteran, will facilitate. I thank you.